Colt 4 has the unique courtroom experience, respect of his peers, and the conservative values we need to be a judge for the people of Livingston, St. Helena, and Tangipahoe parishes. Vote for what matters. Elect Colt 4, District Court
well,
Judge.
Brumfield is well known, active in scouting. You might call him a civic activist. He is the chairman for the upcoming Renaissance Festival in Hammond, but we find him here at the ribbon cutting for Courtney Christian School. It's fair to say that you've been active in local education. What do you think?
I think this is awesome. I mean, the opportunity to expand education, give people a chance to look at different avenues and have different opportunities for learning, especially within their own faith. I think that's just incredible, especially when you look at the results that Courtney Christian has had over the years and their growth. I think it's awesome that kids have more opportunities.
Well, in the meantime, everybody wants to know, is there going to be a Renaissance Festival this fall?
Well, we're kind of in that holding pattern too. You know, the governor's mandate says that we had to ask permission, and we did that. And the next day after we asked, he said it should take about 2 days to process the request. And right now we're at about 3 weeks of waiting. And we've had a lot of people in the last week really step up, try to help us. We've had the Greater Hammond Chamber of Commerce, the Tangipahoe Tourism, Parish President. We've had Representative Bill Wheaton. We have, Bill Wheat. And Nikki Muscarella called me this morning. They're all trying to do their best to get this to work. So we just need an answer. Can we operate or not, since you have a mandate that says we can't? And we know that there's laws that say, well, you can just do it anyway. We're trying to work within the structure. You know, they said apply, so we did. And we're trying to make it a win-win for everybody, because the Louisiana Renaissance Festival is already a really extremely safe place. We're probably safer than any other festival I know. We have actual nurses, registered nurses, medics, EMTs, actual off-duty police officers. We have more sinks to wash your hands than any other festival around here I know of. That was last year without a pandemic, and we've added so much more. We're incredibly safe, but we're trying to follow the rules at the same time, if they'll just work with us.
Well, one thing is, you're all outdoors, and it's a big facility, so there's social distancing whether you want to or not.
This is true. We have we are outdoors. We're in the sun. We can spread out. But, you know, we volunteered. We stepped up to the state, said, we'll limit how many people can come in. We'll do the temperature testing that you want. We'll have a secondary temperature check for those that want it. And last week we even added, if you want to get COVID tested, we have a medical facility there. You can get COVID tested before you come in if you choose to. That price is on you. We can't pay for that. But the option's there. We're doing everything we can to be the safest event. We should be the example that the governor wants us to follow, and we're trying our best to be that, if they'll just simply tell us, yes, you can, or no, you can't, because they have a mandate that says we can't.
One of the things about the Renaissance Festival that locals may not realize, it is a world-class event. It brings people from a multi-state area, and as Renaissance festivals go, it's one of the biggest in the nation.
We are big. We're nowhere near the biggest festival, but we are one of the big guys in the Renaissance Festival. We do bring a lot of tourism to Louisiana, to Tangipahoe Parish. But we would like to not so much focus on the tourism as the outlet. We noticed that after Hurricane Katrina, a lot of people gave us flack for opening, and we consider not doing it. But once we did, our fans were like, thank you. We needed an escape from the pressures and of today and all the drudgery of cleaning up drywall and all that stuff. And right now we've got the whole pandemic. People need a chance to go outside in the sun, safe distancing, with things to do. We can provide that, and we can do it safer than a casino can. I believe we can do it safer than some of these other things that they're allowing to happen in this state. We're safer than that. We just want acknowledgement so that we can go forth without being worried about, oh, you're gonna fine us, you're gonna come in and shut us down. And so we know we're safer. We want them to realize that and clear it so that everybody else can know it's okay to come out, metaphorically put your hair down or realistically let your hair down. Have a great day and just enjoy the Renaissance Festival and step back in time. Forget about the politics of today. Forget about everything of today and just go back to the Renaissance, a time of romance and art.
I know you have a facility on, it's right next to north of Hammond High School, you might say, River Road, but why not just go to another state where things are a lot looser, like Florida or Mississippi?
Well, I know tomorrow Mississippi drops its mask mandate, so you can go there without a mask. Florida is cleared where you can just go there and be free if you want to. And those are options, and if that's what you're wanting, go for it. We're trying to do it where you can be safe, be here, and still have fun. Or you can go to Mississippi and Florida if you need to. It kind of depends on what our options are. They are our options.
But you didn't consider moving.
We didn't really consider moving the Renaissance Festival. People did ask, well, can you move it for 1 year? And we looked at it, and we technically could, but it wouldn't be the same. We have a lot of facilities that make our environment so much better. Like I said, so many more sinks. We have the medical facilities. We're safer, more fun where we're at.
Well, what can a person do to help? Because you don't have the go-ahead yet, and you don't know if you're going to get it.
Today's our own self-imposed deadline, because to make sure we have the quality event, we need about a month, and today's the last day of September that we're recording this, so today's our own day, the close of business day. We're going to decide whether or not we're going forward or not, because we want to be safe, we want to do a quality event, we want everybody to have fun in the best way possible. So at the end of the day, we're going to know whether we're going forward or not. So I would say, hey, email the governor and let him know, but it's really going to be too late at this point. It's going to be a case of, were they responsive or were they not? So at this point, the best way to do it is, if we open, come out and have fun. That's the most you can do.
One of the most important things to me since I've been a judge has been to really be fair and impartial. And it is truly, when people talk about being impartial, the place to be impartial, the place where there's no room for party, there's no room for politics, is in the courtroom. I'm Judge Grace Bennett Gassaway. I love my job, I have the experience, and I would love your vote on November 3rd.